model came out in 1949, and almost 20 years after Helen Weaver's model, Diflor developed their model further. And you see, Shannon and Weaver's model, when I drew it on the board, you saw that it is linear. It doesn't have the element of feedback, which was one of the main criticisms of Shannon and Weaver's model. However, Diflor developed it in a way that it has this feedback element. Yes, noise is there. He says that from source it goes to transmitter, then channels, then receiver, the destination. This is Shannon and Weaver's model going in one direction, linear. And then he says that the same destination can also be source, then transmitter, channel, receiver, destination. In 1970, by that time, TV had started becoming popular. And you see, now his time period is also affecting the development of his model. And then he says that there can be a feedback device as well at the channel, at the point of channel. Noise is a kind of barrier which is affecting in all ways, every element of communication, you see, in this model. And here, actually, this development tells us one thing, at least. And that is that scholars build their views and their works on the basis of what people have done. This person, Diflor, he developed his model on the basis of what Shannon and Weaver had already done. Remember, if maybe some of you know, if some of you have friends who are senior and they are writing thesis or dissertations, you know that they, in their thesis, they have a chapter of literature review where they talk about what other scholars have written on a particular issue. They are writing about a particular issue, they are investigating a particular phenomena, but they build their work on the basis of what others have done. And this is what Diflor did. This is how the knowledge is generated. Like a person proposes something and then there are other scholars who kind of extend his work or improve his work further, and that's what Diflor did. Now, before I end the discussion of Shannon and Weaver model, I want to tell you one important thing, that Shannon and Weaver, unlike Lasker's model, which was specifically about the field of mass communication, Shannon and Weaver model is applied best to human communication, you know, telephone, radio, what I am doing with you, like classroom communication, if you talk to your friend on a cell phone. This model is more applicable on human communication. In case of, if we apply this model on mass communication, yes, it is applicable, but there are little chances of feedback. Like, feedback is limited in, if we apply this on mass communication. This is only downside in terms of its application on mass communication. Other than that, the model actually was important because it kind of provided base for future developments of mass communication and the field of communication itself. With that, we have finished Shannon and Weaver model. If anyone has any question, you can